What's up, everyone? It's TimeRadicherTube, and welcome back to another Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire trailer analysis. Nintendo is going crazy with these trailers. We thought E3 would be the last piece of news for a while, but the next day they reveal a new Mega, and today they reveal even more gameplay and another Mega. It's crazy how much they've been dropping recently, and at this rate, the hype for these games will only get bigger. Anyways, let's take a look at this new trailer in depth. The trailer begins off with you traveling on Mr. Briny's boat from his house on Route 104 to Dewfort Town or Slateport City. Comparing it to the original games, you can see that they turned it into a low-angled cutscene, which makes it look a lot more epic, kind of reminding me of Phantom Hourglass in the Zelda series. We then get a short scene of the two protagonists at the border of Route 102 and Petalburg City. Maybe this is where you're taught how to catch your Pokemon, since in the original games, they indirectly taught you through the scene with Wally catching a Ralts. This shows one of the many camera angles that will be used, and I hope that they'll have the camera change as you walk through the route. I've always liked that. Following that, they show the two bikes in action. The Mach bike allows you to travel much faster and is the only way you can climb up this mudslide, and the Acrobike allows you to hop from one place to another. Like in the original games, you'll need the different bikes to get to different areas. Some people are speculating that Game Freak didn't like the idea of having to switch bikes, which is why there was only one bike in Diamond, Pearl, and Platinum with the ability to switch gears, but I really doubt that because of how unique it was to have different bikes to use. Berry trees can be seen on the left, confirming that they'll return, and a TM can be seen in the distance, confirming that they will maintain the same item differentiation they introduced in X and Y. We also get to see the key move your rival does each time something happens. Mei apparently thinks she's Goku and throws a fist in the air. They then showcase the three Hoenn starters mega evolving and fighting off against each other. If you look carefully, you can see Sceptile shoots its tail at the enemy, which is pretty interesting because I don't think they've ever had a move where a part of the Pokemon is actually thrown or separated from its body. And I must say, Swampert's a bit too happy that he can finally Mega Evolve. They showcase the grunts for both teams, and unlike X and Y, the grunts don't have 3D models and are instead just 2D sprites, but these recreated graphics for them do look really nice. They also showcase Primal Kyogre and Primal Groudon, and them using new signature moves we haven't seen before. I'm actually really excited to see what these new moves could be, as some people have even went as far as saying that Groudon's new move may be a dual ground and fire type move. They also mentioned earlier that these two would be getting a boost to their abilities, which is leading us to speculating that they will possess abilities that can summon permanent weather conditions, like how it used to be before X and Y came out. And right when we thought it was over, they officially announced Mega Niantic, making it look like the princess of all rocks. It maintains its rock and fairy typing, but there's no information at all on its ability. They also mentioned that Niantic will be distributed to X and Y, and then Mega Evolvable in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. So either they're gonna force you to trade it from X and Y, or they're gonna have an event for Niantic in these new games. It just seems so out of the ordinary for Niantic to get a Mega Evolution, but the more Megas the better, right? Well, that's debatable. We don't want this to become a thing. But anyways, that's it for this analysis. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like. Let me know what you think about Mega Niantic, especially what ability it could have. I was disappointed that Niantic's normal ability was Clear Body, but now there's a possibility that it will get an actual good ability. There's a lot more Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire information to cover, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out.